Hello friends, welcome back. Today video session we are going to talk about how to implement pagination in JPA. Implementing pagination in JPA is very easy. By adding a few lines, easily we can implement pagination. Now we are going to see how to implement pagination two different ways. Okay. For that, I created one object class called product. The product so it's a POJO object, entity object. It has only four column, and I created a controller for that controller, product controller. In that product controller, I have a save product. Okay, using this method, I already saved multiple products in my database. When you look at the database, see, I have a totally 22 products are inserted. I want to paginate this product 5x5. Okay, I want to paginate this product 5x5. Okay, at a time whenever fetch all the product, I want display first 5 item, then next 5 item, like that I want to implement. Okay, here there is a two get mapping. These both get mapping for achieve a product for pagination. The both the method doing the pagination, but different approach. Product service find all. That's I created one more service class called find all. That find all accept two parameter, page number and pages. Page number nothing but which page number you want to view, which page number you want to view, then which page and what is the page size of that. Okay, page number nothing but page 1, page 2, page 3, then each page how many record you want to display, that is determined by page size. Okay, page number start with 0, page size can be anything, that is our wish. You can give 5 or 10, 3, like that you can give. The product controller, when you look at here, I am passing request page number, page size using the request param. From the client side, I am accepting page number, page size. Client will tell which page number they wanted to use, how many records they wanted to use in that page, in the particular page. For example, I want to view first page, means here we have to pass 0. Here we have to pass 0. Then the 0th page, how many records they want to view. If you want to view 5 records, means we need to pass here 5. Okay, now then that particular, these values I am passing to find all method, which is coming from product service. Here there is a Spring JPA API called pageable. Pageable equal to page request of. Page request of, we have to pass 3 parameter. We can pass 2 also, I think. Okay, I'll show with 2 now. Okay, page request of, page number, page size. I'm requesting to the database, I want to view first page. If you pass 0 means first page. From the first page, I want to view 5 records. That is the meaning of this particular line. Okay. From the 0th record, I want to view 5 records. If you pass 1, what will happen? From the 6th record, it will display 5 records. If you pass 2, from 11th record, it will show 5 records. Like that. That is called as a page number. Here, I am passing. I defined how many, what is the page number and what is the page size through this particular line. The second line I am passing them, I am calling a find all method from product repository. The find all method coming from the product repository. Here I am passing that pageable object. This pageable object only having how many page, which page number, how many record you want to view in that page, in the particular page. That definition available in that pageable object, right? Here I am passing that. Here I am defining that and I am passing here. So that record only returned by this particular find all method. This find all method return product and the page. It return a page object. That page object binded with the product information as well as other page related information. For example, let's say I want to whenever invoke this method, this return, let's say, return a 0 to 5 record. Apart from that, there are many page related information for like how many total record, what is the page size, those information this particular page object hold. I will when you see the demo definitely will understand what's there in the page object. Okay, this page object return products as well as a pagination information, page informations. Okay, let's see the demo for this now. Okay, I'm going to start the server now. I'm going to change product page. Then here I'm going to change product page. When you see that the page object, I'm going to show that. See, for example, get total page. How many pages available here? Get total page. For example, when you look at the database, there are 22 records, right? So I want to display 5-5. So 5-5 meaning the total 20 record will have a 5 pages. Okay, 5 pages. Last page will have only 2 records. Okay. So this total records, get total page return 5. Like that total element, how many records available in the database? The total element, we will return only first 5 records, but the total element return 22 records. So like that, some page information we can get through the page object. Apart from that, the page object holds the record. I'll go into print that also here now. Print again. Get total elements. Total elements. Then get total pages. So let's see what's printing here. Going to restart the application, run. What is the endpoint for this? Find all, get mapping. Just get mapping API products. When you say API products, by passing if you say get method, this method get invoke that return products in the form of page object. Okay, if you pass page number is a 0, if you pass page number is a size, for example, let's say I'm going to pass 5 means 5 records return, 0 to 5 records return. Okay, now I'm going to add a get http colon localhost. Products, say page number, here I'm passing. Here API products, then get method. Then I am calling this get method now. This get method having a slash query, right? So I am calling this one now. When I say page number I am passing 1. Sorry, page number I am passing 0. 0 means first page. 0 means first page. How many page size 5? That is how many record you want to display in the first page. Sending request. See here, I am getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Only 5 records I am getting. Let's say I am going to say page size is equal to 6. I print some value here, right? What I printed here? The product controller. Here, yeah. Total elements. So total elements 22. Total element 22 nothing but total number of records available in the database, 22 records. Then total page is 5. Since I mentioned I passed here 5, 22 divided by 5, so 5 record will come. So 0 to 1 to 5, so one page. 6 to 10 is a second page. 11 to 15 is a third page. 16 to 20 is a fourth page. 21 to 22, fifth page. So it's giving a total page is 5. So whenever you use this find all method, that method return a page object. That page object contain page information as well as product information. Okay, that's what we are getting here. See, 5 records. Let's say I'm going to pass 6 now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 records, right? Okay. When you look at the repository method, just I'm not passing any query here. Just I'm calling find all, then passing a pageable as a parameter. Then it will return a products with a pagination information. The second method is I'm writing my query manually. Explicitly, I'm mentioning the query. Select product from product. Okay. Then my method name is find all products. Then passing the pageable object. Pageable object. In this case, I am returning all the value in the form of list object. Here we are returning only the product information. Here we are not returning any page related information. Pagination information we are not returning. Only the product information we are returning page wise. See this method I am calling here. Product service or find all product. I am passing page number, page size. Page number, page size. Similarly, page number I am passing in the creating a pageable object. The pageable object I am passing in the find all product method. Find all product method here. Okay, here page number and page size. Also, we can say sort by which column you want to sort. And sorting, is it descending or ascending? That also we can mention. Here also we can do. Okay, like sort by reptile. Okay, now we're going to see this example now. In this example, we cannot get this. We cannot get this kind of information. Let's see what is there in pageable object. Pageable dot get page size. We have a page size. Since we are passing a page size, it has a page size. Page size, then pageable dot page size, page number, no need. If you want to get a total page, number of element method not available in this case. In this approach, we cannot get the number of element, but you can take it, I think. Yeah, that is not possible here. We don't see any method like that. We have some other method only. But here in this approach, we can get the total elements, total pages. There are many useful methods are available in the case of if you implement the pagination using page object. Okay, let's see this one now. Now I am going to execute this method, this particular query. So here I am going to say slash query. So since I am saying descending, here I am saying a descending, right? The final product I am saying descending, it's giving the last five record it's giving. Let's say I'm going to pass saying ascending. What will happen? You're getting 22, 21, 20, 20, 19, right? Sorry, started now. I am going to say now it will give 125. See, 125. So it's a pagination and a shorting mechanism is very, very easy in the case of JPA. Okay, JPA makes our life very easy in the last some days, yes, some years back. If you want to implement a pagination, if you want to implement a sorting mechanism, for that, for everything we need to write a Java code, right? But JPA having ready-made API, by using that API we can implement the pagination very simply. Okay. If you want to make this column dynamically, I want to short whatever column I want. How to do that? Now, in such a case, you have to pass this value dynamically. You have to add one more parameter here, one more argument here. Then, in the product controller, you need to pass one more request param called column. Column, that column, whatever column you are passing here, that column will we need to pass here. That's it. So through that way we can make that dynamically, we can change the column for shorting mechanism. Okay, that's it guys, today's session. Okay, from next I think almost we have covered Spring Boot and the RESTful web services. I think this would be the sufficient to work with your Spring Boot application. But still, I will going to post more topics in the part of Spring Boot, like Spring Security, OOP programming. Okay, we will go to see some good videos in upcoming session. So one more thing, all the video session I have done some coding, right? All updated code available in the GitHub URL. Each and every video, the description section, I have mentioned that the GitHub URL. Click that GitHub URL and take the example code, latest code. All the video description I have added that GitHub links. Please don't forget to take that source code. Still, if you are not subscribed, please subscribe the channel. Please share it to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching full video. Until then, bye bye from Suresh Stalin.